This is MAT 2019 in 10 minutes or less. I'm James Munro. Let's go. 1a. The left-hand side of this equation is a cubic, and its turning points are at x is plus or minus 10. The value on the right-hand side is bigger than the value at the turning points, so there's exactly one solution, and the answer is b. 1b. If you try some small square and cube numbers, you'll find, for example, 1 times 1 is 1, but 4 times 8 is 32, which is neither the square nor cube. So the answer is sometimes a square, sometimes a cube, and the answer is C. 1c. This sum is a geometric series, which we could do, or we could just note that when x is 0, the sum is 0, and when x is 90 degrees, the sum diverges. So the graph is D. 1d. The parabolas intersect at x equals 0 and x is minus a. We need to consider the cases a less than 0 and a bigger than 0 separately. If we do the integral for the difference between the parabolas, we find that the area is plus or minus a cubed over 3. So a has to be 3 or minus 3, and the answer is b. 1e. We're looking for solutions of the form y equals mx plus c. We could take y equals x, that works, or we could take y equals x plus 360 degrees or plus 720 degrees. There are infinitely many lines that work, and the answer is E. 1f. Write cos squared is 1 minus sine squared, and this becomes a cubic for sine x. We'd like to know how many roots this cubic has got, so find its turning points, and it turns out there's only one solution to the cubic. One value of sine x means two solutions for x, so the answer is C. 1g. Get rid of all the logarithms and try and solve these equations. If we raise the middle one to the power of c, we get b on the left, and b to a quadratic in c on the right-hand side. Because b isn't 1 for these logarithms to make sense, we must have the quadratic equal to 1. Solve this for positive c to find that c is a half, and the other equations become a equals b squared and a is 2 to the minus b. A quick sketch shows that there's a unique solution to these equations, so the answer is a. 1h. Call the sides a, ar, and ar squared. Pythagoras gives 1 plus r squared is r to the 4. Solve this quadratic for r squared to find r is the square root of 1 plus root 5 over 2. Now, tan bac might be r, or it might be 1 over r, depending on which corner is a. Some algebra gives the answer to be c. 1i. Both x and 2 to the x are strictly increasing, so x 2 to the x is a strictly increasing function of x. That means there's no solutions x less than y to this equation, and the answer is a. 1j. Let's imagine we had a straight line through O and one of the corners of the triangle, and then we rotated it by an angle of theta. That function's periodic, with period 60 degrees every time the line goes through another corner of the triangle, and it's symmetric in theta because rotating in the opposite direction does the same thing. The minimum therefore occurs halfway in between those maximum values when it goes through the corners, when the line is parallel to one of the sides of the triangle. In that case, some geometry shows that the length of PQ is 2/3, and the answer is D. Question 2, part 1. Taking the highest power of x on the left, we find that n is k times k plus 1 over 2. Part 2. X equals 1 on the left gives 2 to the k, but x equals 1 on the right gives the sum of the coefficients. The sum of the coefficients is, at most, n plus 1 times the biggest coefficient. Part 3. Once k is bigger than I, we get from pk of x to pk plus 1 of x by multiplying by 1 plus x to the k, where x to the k is some huge power of x. That doesn't affect the coefficient of x to the I. Part 4. Substitute in 1 over x and multiply through by x to the power of n. On the left, we get back to pk of x, and on the right, we get the coefficients in reverse order. Part 5. There are only n plus 1 coefficients, but we showed in part 2 that the biggest coefficient is bigger than 2 to the k over n plus 1. In order to get all of the numbers in the coefficients, we need n plus 1 squared to be bigger than 2 to the k, but that's not true for large k, so the student is wrong. Question 3, part 1. The integral is c cubed over 6. For the area of S, translate the parabola in the question left until the roots are 0 and b minus a. Then the area of S is exactly the integral we've just done, with c equal to b minus a. Part 2. Set mx equal to the equation of the parabola to get a quadratic. We want a repeated root, so the discriminant must be 0. Rearrange this for m. Part 3. The area of S is beta squared minus 1 all cubed over 6. Set this equal to the expression for the area of R and simplify. We're interested in solutions to this equation, so look at the quartic in brackets. When beta is 1, the value is minus 3, but for very large beta, it's clearly positive. So somewhere in between, there must be a solution. Question 4, part 1. If AB is inside the circle, then the closest point is AB itself. If AB is outside the circle, then the closest point is on the edge at AB over the square root of a squared plus b squared. Part 2. For example, we could have the disk x squared plus y squared strictly less than 1 with no edge. There are points outside the disk. There's no closest point. Part 3. This time we could use a circle x squared plus y squared equals 1 and think about the point in the centre. Part 4. Use Pythagoras to find an expression for the distance d. Now, d squared is a quadratic in x with a positive leading coefficient, so it's got a unique minimum, and that's a minimum of d. Part 5. For points in this set, x plus 2/5 is half of y minus 1/5, and that's the equation of a straight line, and in fact all of the points on that straight line are in S. Part 6. Suppose there are two closest points inside the set S. Think about the line segment joining those two points. Along the line, the distance squared is a quadratic with equal values at the endpoints of that line segment, so halfway in between it takes a new minimum. By the property we're given, that point's also in the set S, so contradiction, an even closer point exists. Question 5, part 1. Each subset has two or more elements, so you need at least 2k elements overall to have a successful partition. Part 2. If n equals 1, then this is 0 by the previous part. If n's bigger than 1, then there's exactly one partition. Put all the elements together in one subset. Part 3. In the first case, we've got n choices for which single element we're going to pair with n plus 1, and in the second case, we've got k choices of which subset to add n plus 1 into. So we can put that together to give f n plus 1k is equal to n times f n minus 1k minus 1 plus k times f mk. Part 4, using this result we can build up from small values of n and k to find that f7 3 is 105. Part 5, we've got two n items and we'd like to split them into n pairs. There are two n factorial ways to write down the elements in our set. And then when we pair them up, the order inside the pairs doesn't matter, and the order of the pairs doesn't matter. Final answer, 2n factorial over n factorial 2 to the n. Question 6, part 1. Following the rules, we find the next flexadecimal numbers are 21, 100, 101, 110, 111, 120, 121, 200, and then 201. Part 2. Thinking about when we carry over to a new digit, we see that the place value of the kth digit is k factorial. So multiply each digit by the corresponding factorial and sum them up to find the value in decimal. Part 3. To convert a number to flexadecimal, we'll need to find the biggest factorial that's smaller than the target number. The quotient gives us the first digit of the flexadecimal number, and then we continue the calculation down through smaller factorials. For example, 255 turns out to be 20211. Part 4, we're going to add the digits together starting from the right, and if we find that the digit in the kth place is too big, we can subtract k plus 1 and carry 1 over to the next digit up. Part 5, only the last two digits matter because all the other factorials are multiples of 3. If the last two digits are 0, 0 or 1, 1, then the whole number is a multiple of 3. Part 6. The list of arrangements is sorted into 6 blocks by the first letter of the arrangement. Our flexadecimal number starts with 3, so we're somewhere in the 4th block, the arrangements that start with D. Inside that block, we've got arrangements of the letters A, B, C, E, F, and we can look at the next digit of the flexadecimal number to find out how far through the block we are. If we continue this process through the digits of the flexadecimal number, we find that we're at D, F, B, A, E, C. Question 7, part 1. The box has only got n digits, so there's only finitely many different things it can display. After a while, then, it has to repeat itself and come back to something we've seen before. Part 2. Xi plus s is what we see s button presses after xi, but that's also what we'll see s button presses after xj. Part 3. I is bigger than m, so we can write I as m plus s for some s. Then xi plus kp means xm plus kp plus s. Now we're going to use the previous part. We know that xm is equal to m plus kp, so xm plus s is the same thing as xm plus kp plus s. Part 4. First note that if j minus I is a multiple of p, then by part 3, xj is the same thing as xi. Now suppose instead that j minus I is r more than a multiple of p, with r less than p. So there's a point r presses before we got to xj, with the same value as xj. But p is supposed to be the smallest number of button presses for values to repeat, so r has to be 0. And that means that j minus I is a multiple of p. Part 5. U has to be at least m because we've got into the loop, and after a further u presses, we've done a whole number of loops, so u must be a multiple of p. Putting it together, that means that u is the smallest multiple of p that is at least m. part 6, you could reset the boxes and give one of them a U-press head start. Now press the buttons together until the displays agree. That happens after exactly M presses. Part 7, reset the boxes and press each button M times. They're now ready to loop. Leave one of them alone and press the other button until the displays agree. That happens after P presses. That was Matt 2019 in 10 minutes or less. For more Matt, go to www.maths.ox.ac.uk/r/Matt. There's a link on that page for comments and corrections. Thank you.